Hello, this is the RPG Chick here with some potentially, well, some bad, potentially worse news as far as Fallout 2 is concerned. I started having some Windows problems about a week ago from this day. Actually happened when I tried to I did shut down the computer and it said configuring updates and it went to 30% and then shut off. And I was like, that's unusual, but I was going on a trip and I'm like, okay, well, I guess that last 70% was instantaneous. Came back and, well, took altogether like 4 or 5 hours for me to boot up my computer. I had to select the repair option. With Windows, I'm using Windows 7, 64-bit Windows 7 Professional. The repair really didn't work that well. I mean, Windows would start her up, but every time I try to restart the computer, it would take several hours for it to start. It's pretty inconvenient. Once it would start, it seemed to work fine. The only difference is this 250 gigabyte SSD that has the majority of my games on it will not be recognized. It's weird. It's recognized as a disk drive in Device Manager, but I can't get it in computer management, disk management, or, you know, to show up in my computer, you know, drives to mess with. My Fallout 2 saves are on here. Every single save is on here. Normally I back up stuff, but I've been really, really busy, and that just slipped through the cracks there. So I'm gonna see if maybe I could do a data recovery on it. Maybe there's something wrong with it. Because it sees it as a disk. It's just not loading it. I can't put a drive letter to it. I can't get anything off this thing. You know, it's happened before several times in the past. And I thought it was my SATA cable or something like that. Or the power cable going to the motherboard, which are the two cables that you plug into this thing. But, nope, because I took those out of my hard disk drive, and, I plugged those cables into my hard disk drive, and everything works fine, so. And I plugged the other cables from the hard disk drive into this SSD, not working right, so you can hear it. This is it. This has the Fallout 2 save, so what I'm looking at currently, well, I guess I gotta shop around. They're saying typically $90 flat rate for, you know, to recover data. So I've seen other areas other places will charge $1 a gig. There isn't that much on this. I'm thinking this. I have the 45 gigs in my mind for some reason. I don't know if you can choose what you want recovered, because there might not be file names, you know, associated with that. There might not be an option. I've never done this before, so they might, you know, it's just recover everything. All I need is the saves. All I need is my Fallout 2 directory. And I guess the mod would be helpful too. The mod that we have for Fallout 2. I think it is called the restoration mod. But I'm prepared to do something like that because I don't want to. $90. Like I say, maybe I can find somewhere cheaper. Maybe they can fix this drive. Maybe there's something on it. Maybe it is. I mean, Windows has no idea what to do with this thing. It says the drivers are up to date, but it doesn't know what it is. So how can the drivers be up to date if you don't know what this is? You don't even know what kind of disk. It just says disk drive in computer, not computer, device manager. So it's the strangest thing. So my file's on here, so I cannot play any Fallout 2 until I get my files off of here, which, if it is possible, I have to evaluate, see, you know, who can do this, if I can't afford it, if I should be able to be doing this at this time. I'm really saving up money to, you know. The stuff with my daughter is still going on. I'm saving money to either have her come out here or for me to go down where she is. So, I really don't want to be throwing... I just got a monitor. I don't think I told anyone this, but I just got a new monitor because my original monitor crapped out. So, I have stuff failing on me now. Even my computer chair that I always sat in today... It decided it doesn't lean back anymore. So I'm in another chair, which is not as comfortable and doesn't go down as far as I like. I feel like I'm elevated too much off of, you know, away from my desk. I don't know what the hell to do. I don't know what I'm doing. But, hopefully I can get info off of this thing. Now, the only thing is, I'd have to do it. I have an extended warranty, a 3-year warranty on this thing. So if it is a drive malfunction and I can't access things, I can't use this drive anymore. I have just a little under a month, like 28 days or 29 days, something like that, to, you know, take advantage of this warranty on this so they can send me a new one. So... I don't know what's involved with data recovery. I don't know if they have to take the disk apart or something like that. In which case, that would void the warrant. That would void the warranty, obviously. You can't take the thing apart. Unless they can put it back together to where you can't tell and that kind of... I don't know. I doubt it. You can tell it's been tampered with, I'm sure. So, I'm not sure... What I'm doing at this point, sometime this week, I'm going to have these guys look at this drive. I really just want to play more Fallout. I am completely out of backlog. What you saw, episode 148 is the newest episode. I have not played past there. There's no more files to upload, no more files to edit, anything like that. So that's where we currently are. So, and I've been bummed about it, you know, I feel like I'm struggling. At this point in my life, I feel like I'm struggling with almost every single aspect of my life. Everything. I feel like I'm struggling, I feel like everyone in my life is, I'm either struggling for or struggling against. I feel like I'm ill-prepared to... handle this. I need to play these games. This is my escape from reality. Well, this partial escape from reality, because I'm aware that I'm recording for you guys, and, you know, the comments and the likes and all that stuff is really appreciated, so that helps too. But this simple act of playing these games is enjoyable. You know, and it's a hobby, it's fun, it's something, you know, I can do where I feel like I'm progressing at some point in my life. I'm progressing, I'm gaining levels, I'm getting closer to the end of the game, I'm getting more powerful, blah, blah, blah. Because everything in my life feels like it's stopped at a standstill. I feel like it's either stopped, can't go forward, or I feel like it's declining. You know, this is, you know, it's nothing, I'm not talking about that I'm going to die soon or anything like that, or my health is failing, it's just, I mean, I have that, such as it is. There's just so much crap going on right now, I just can't even. So, I'm not going to make a video every time, but stay tuned with the community tab. We have a new community tab, for those who don't know. Used to be you had to... just looking at this thing. I thought this was a button or reset thing, but it's actually... That's a screw. That is a little screw. For a tiny Phillips head screwdriver. Community tab. I'm going to post there. I mean, maybe I'll post things on Twitter, stuff like that, too. I'm not sure how many people pay attention to Twitter. I did post something on a community tab a few weeks ago about Amber Star going, you know, for Thanksgiving. We had 3 episodes, and then for before Thanksgiving, we're going to have 3 episodes. I think the 22nd, the 23rd, and the 24th, which is a Monday, we're going to have 3 episodes. So I posted something about that on the, the community tab, and I got, like, a bunch of likes and a comment, so people saw it. I was like, when? So I might just post updates on this over there. Other than that, I was able to work with Microsoft customer support, and they might have fixed the problem. I don't know. Because at some point, my USB devices just all failed on me, and I went to reset the computer, and then it went back to taking over an hour to reset again. But then I restored from a save point, a restore point actually for Windows that the Microsoft guy set up for me, which, I've heard about that. I didn't know it was involved setting up a restore point. I thought I needed a separate hard drive for that. I'm tech savvy to a certain point after that. I'm just like, so I was watching him do this stuff, and I'm like, okay. So I'm back to the previous save point, which seems to be, I don't know what it is. I really don't know what the issue is. So, but once I get Windows up, it seems to be fine. I just don't have this drive. And quote unquote, it seems to be fine. So that's what we're dealing with here, and I gotta find out what's going on with the data recovery. If we can do it without voiding the warranty, I want to do it quickly so I can also get a free replacement to this thing, because 3 years warranty, this thing craps out on me, apparently, 2 years and 11 months into the warranty. So, yeah, I want to take advantage of that if I can. So, for you guys, on all my videos, be including this one, I have links to Patreon. I have links to PayPal. So if anyone wants to donate to help me out with this particular malady, or just in general, I'd appreciate it. I don't know why I'm losing my voice. I don't expect it. It's fine if you don't. Just putting it out there, because some people are like, oh, I didn't know you had a Patreon. You should have said something. And then I got people who are like, stop talking about your damn Patreon. So, damned if you do, damned if you don't. So I figured, screw those people. For those who would be interested in supporting the channel, I have a Patreon. Links are on every video, along with everything else. Yeah, under the description of the, what happens in the episode. And the playlist info, which is a quick little thing where you can get to the entire playlist. I like putting that in, because it's not always readily apparent on YouTube. So, kind of a pain to go back to my channel and try to find a playlist from something I posted 3 years ago. So, thinking of putting up some other games in the meantime. So, I'm not completely sure what those will be. I want a backlog, so I don't know. I guess don't expect anything for this week, but if it shows up, hey, sweet. So, yeah, I want a backlog of vids. I want to, do my thing. So, I do have an extra 120 gigabyte hard drive, which I was going to use to replace my system drive. So if my system drive is failing, I might use that as my new system drive. The only problem is I can't get a copy of Windows 7 because now they have ISOs. They have ISO files up on Microsoft.com where you can download versions of Windows, I think 7 through 10. You just need the product key. Now, I used my product key, and it's OEM, original manufacturer. They told me, well, they didn't tell me, it's the message that came up once I put in that product key. I need to contact my original manufacturer, which is iBuyPower, which I got this computer way back in 2012. And I contacted them. They don't have Windows 7 disks. They no longer deal with Windows 7. So, which I don't blame them for, because 7 isn't really current anymore. It's basically 10 or 8, which are the current ones. So Microsoft wouldn't give me another product key, and iBuyPower apparently don't have one to give me. So I would really like to reinstall Windows all over again on a new hard drive, but doesn't seem to be like I can do that for under $200. Sorry about that. I'm leaning back in my chair and the mic keeps scraping on me. I will sit up. So this chair's not as comfortable as the other one. No way. My back's like hurting me already. So, yeah, like blabbed on quite enough. So you might see stuff from me. Amber Star is still current. You know, I might catch up with that a little bit more. Of course, you're not going to see that till later. But I think I want to put out some videos of some kind, you know, just to, you know, feel some sense of accomplishment, and that gives me strength to go forward, believe it or not. This is my drive to go forward. This is my fun thing that makes the struggle and everything like that easier to deal with. So thanks for listening, thanks for all that stuff, and yeah, here's hoping soon I come out with an update that says, hey, I was able to retrieve this stuff with no problem, and it didn't cost me a fortune, and Fallout 2 will continue. You know, that's of course, we hope that will be the outcome, unless this drive is completely scragged for some reason, which it still recognizes it. Device Manager recognizes it, like I said, as a disk drive. I just can't get at the data in it. I can't map a letter to it. I can't, like, work with it. So I gotta find out what the hell is going on with this and what I can do. So I played Fallout, I looked at it, it was like about 88 hours. Could you imagine playing that all over again? That's really difficult. It would take a long time to do that, because I would be trying to replicate everything as on the original Let's Play, so that I could pick right up. And in some cases, that would be very difficult to do, because it's some of the things are that you achieve in Fallout are based on chance. Pass a skill check that you do it again and you fail it, so then you have to do it over and over again. You know, if I were to do it in the second playthrough, it would be longer than playing through it, because I'd actually have to do everything the same. So it would be ridiculous. And it's been ridiculous. I've been talking about this for over 20 minutes. So yeah, wish me luck, guys. Donations are appreciated, but not expected. They're out there, options, you know, take them or not. And yeah, I'll see you in something soon, I hope. If anything, Amber Star is going to continue on, so that'd be Saturday, Sunday. So if anything, we'll have that. At least I'm good until all of December for that. So thanks for watching and listening, and see you soon. Always seek adventure.